Hi, I'm Patty James, co-author of the upcoming book with Dr. Elson Haas entitled More Vegetables, Please. And today, I'd like to make you my brown rice salad. It's one of my favorite rice salads. I use brown basmati rice and pack it with all sorts of great vegetables and nuts and seeds because I truly believe that vegetables are the key to health. And everybody needs to eat more vegetables. And today you're going to learn some easy tricks about how to do just that. Every meal of the day, including snacks and even breakfast. But today, let's concentrate on our brown rice salad. My favorite is basmati brown rice. So you just cook it, have it in your refrigerator. You can cook it in the morning. One cup rice to 2 cups of water. It takes about 45 minutes, and then you cool that. And then you put that in a bowl, just like I have right here. And then we're going to be chopping up a lot of vegetables, adding it to our brown rice, making a nice little vinaigrette. And this is my daughter, Catherine. And she's going to be chopping up some herbs and various vegetables, and we're just going to make this beautiful salad. So let's get cooking. All right, so here's our brown rice. Let's start, I won't start with an onion in case I get all teary. We'll do that last. I have some red pepper here, so I'm just going to slice some red pepper in little slices. Catherine is working, got me too, right in the eyes. Catherine is working on the carrots, nice little chopped fine carrots. Carrots, of course, are beta-carotene, and there's vitamin C in this red pepper. I try to use lots of different colored vegetables because every vegetable has a different nutrient. So it's very important to use a lot of different colored vegetables. I even have a raw zucchini. And you notice that I keep all my trimmings in a bowl, and then I make vegetable stock. But we'll talk more about that later. So keep all your trimmings. So here's a nice piece of raw zucchini. Again, raw foods are very important. They're highly enzymatic and very nutritious. So we're doing a nice zucchini, chopped fine. You can use crookneck. And again, feel free to change any of these vegetables with the seasons. Seasonal eating is the thing to do. So here's my red onion. I'm cutting off the ends. And yes, I'm putting the onion skins in my stock bowl as well. And you know, sometimes at home when you're not cooking I'm cutting through just a little bit of the skin so I can take the outer layer off. But back to what I was saying, you don't oftentimes do this kind of quantity. So all you have to do is put these vegetable trimmings in a bag in the freezer. And when the bag is full, empty it out in a stock pot, cover it with cold water, simmer it for a half an hour or so, and you have stock. You just strain it. Okay. Here's our red onion. So you cut it in half. All right, be careful. And face it downward. And then hands flat. Some people do this, but I prefer to keep the ends of my fingers. So just to be extra careful. So you just slice it through. Whoops, this piece was loose. Till it hits the end, but not quite. I had like two little onions on a row there. So it goes to the end, but not quite all the way to the end, so it stays intact, okay? So what you notice, I didn't go all the way through. And then the tip of your knife, you go this way. And again, I'm not going all the way to the end. And you can make the onion as fine as you want, depending on how many times you do this, both directions, horizontally and now this kind of a cut. And that way, when you do cut it, you notice tips of my fingers are right next to the knife. When you do cut it, I have this beautiful little dice. And let's see, that looks like about enough. I'll keep this for something else. So nice, fine little dice. Isn't that pretty? So far, we have just great colors in here. Okay. Now, Catherine is doing the carrots. I'm going to do some celery. So we just, again, cut the ends off. Those don't look really great. Sometimes I just top them right up if they do. Okay, that onion got me a little bit, but not too bad. In our stock pot, in fact, I'm going to move it. There you go. All right, so sliced. I think I'll cut these down just so they're a little smaller. And and just a little sliced celery. And I cut right through and include the leaves. I never understood why people didn't like celery leaves. They're very healthy. They taste good. They have a little kick to them. I like them. So I add the celery. Okay, now what else? So let's go back to seasonal eating. You could put, you could just fresh corn. You don't even have to cook it. Just take it right off the stalk and put it right in. You could use peas. In the summertime, you could add some cherry tomatoes. Now, the thing when you do add tomatoes, however, is that they can tend to soften it up. And this salad can last for a good day, but not necessarily with tomatoes. So you might just serve those on the top. Another good thing to do is to add beans. You can just open a can of, say, black beans. And with black beans, you can change up your spices. I could have diced up a little jalapeno in here, too, or put it in the salad dressing. But beans and rice contain, the combination contain all the necessary amino acids. So adding white beans or black beans or whatever, kidney beans, garbanzo beans, whatever kind of beans you have to add to this would be very good as well. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to toast some almonds. So here's some sliced almonds, and you don't have to toast the almonds, but I want to show you how to do it. And besides that, when you toast your nuts and seeds, they have a little bit more depth of flavor. So I toast my seeds just to have it in a bowl on the countertop. You don't want to buy your nuts and seeds roasted. Always buy your nuts and seeds raw, because you don't know what kind of oil they've been roasted in, and you don't know how long they've been oxidized, in other words, exposed to oxygen. So I would prefer that you buy your nuts and seeds raw, and then just lightly toast them yourself if you want to do that, okay? Which we're going to do right now. Let's go over to the stove and toast some seeds and nuts. Here's our nice stainless steel pan that's warm on the stove and some sliced almonds. I don't need quite all of these. I'm going to put about half of those. It's about a third of a cup or half of a cup in this pan. And these are not going to take very long at all to roast. They're just going to get aromatic and slightly brown. And then we're going to take them out of the pan so they do not continue to cook, put them on the plate and let them cool, and then add them to our salad. Yeah, these are almost ready to be out of here, actually. Okay. Okay, here's our sliced almonds. We'll put most of those in the salad. I'm going to save a few for the top. Catherine, you want to bring over those carrots and put those in the bowl? And I'll toss this up. Thank you. Just dump it in. And then chop up some of that parsley. So we're going to add some parsley to this and save a little bit for the top. Okay, that is beautiful. Okay, now I'm going to make a quick vinaigrette. So all I'm going to do, here's our bowl and a clove of garlic. Just smash that underneath the blade away from you. Smash that, take the skin off, put the skins in your vegetable stock bowl, and just chop that up finely minced. Whoops, there's another little piece there. Sticks to your hands. Okay, and you can smash it a little bit too if you like. All right. Okay, so I'm going to put this in our bowl with apple cider vinegar and some pepper. You know, you can put Dijon mustard in here. You can, just about any kind of flavoring that you can think of. I also have a little bit of hemp oil, very high in omega-6s, but omega-3s as well, and a ratio between the two, which is important. I'm going to use a little olive oil as well. So you notice I didn't measure, but you can kind of tell by smelling, but this garlic is nice. Ground pepper. You can put a little sea salt in there if you like. So I have a garlic clove. Let's see how this smells. Oh, that smells very nice. I'm going to add, it just for fun, a little bit of lemon juice too. You can just pour it right through your fingers, and if there's seeds, just let it go right through your fingers, and then you can just toss the seeds away. If you catch them in your hands. There you go. Oh, that's nice. All right. So I'm going to pour this on the salad. All right. mix this up. Pretty. Let's put that in our pretty big bowl for serving. Okay, and then we'll garnish that with some sunflower sprouts. Aren't those pretty? Catherine, want to bring over those? Thank you. Just go ahead and throw some on the top. Ah, parsley, very good for your liver. It's a bitter herb. So here's our beautiful brown rice salad, chock full of lots of different kinds of vegetables, topped with toasted nuts and seeds and sunflowers. It's just beautiful, smells great. You're going to love it. Enjoy.